Hello viewers, welcome to GG Study Circle Tindakal. Last some sessions we have seen quick squares. From this video onwards, we see some super fast multiplication. How we can multiply quickly. First we will see, to multiply any number by 11 or 12 or 15. First we will see how to multiply a two digit number by 11. You take an example, 27 into 11. In this case, you write the unit digit as it is 7. And then add these two digits. Because 11 is in two digits, you add this 7 plus 2, that is second step. 7 plus 2, 9. And then third step, you leave 7 and put 2 as it is. So you can write first 7. And then 7 plus 2, 9, and then 2 as it is. You can take another example, 89 into 11. How can you multiply? You put 9 as it is, the unit digit as it is. And then add these two numbers, 9 plus 8, 17. You take the unit digit of 17, 7. You take the balance 1 in your mind. 1 is the balance. And leave 9 and add that 1 with this 8, you get 9. So first you take the unit digit 9 as it is, and then 9 plus 8, 17, the balance is 1. You add 1 with this 8, leaving that 9. 1 plus 8, 9. So 9, 7, 9 is nothing but 89 into 11. You suppose it is a 3 digit number, how can we multiply? You take an example, 386. 386 is in 3 digits. First, we have to write the unit digit as it is. That is the usual step. Unit digit is as it is. And then add this unit digit and tenth digit. 6 plus 8, that is 14. You take 14, the unit digit of 14, and make that 1 as balance. Then, now 11 is in 2 digit. You take 6 and 8, you have already taken. So bear in mind, 1 is balance. And now you leave the unit digit and add these two numbers. 1 plus 8 plus 3. If you want, you can put this 1 here. 1 plus 8 plus 3. 1 plus 8 plus 3, 12. Now 1 is catchy figure. You can take this catchy figure. Now you leave 8 and then 1 plus 3 is 4. So you can write like this, 6 as it is. 6 plus 8, 14. 1 catchy figure. Then leave 6. 1 plus 8 plus 3, 12. 1 is catching where you leave 8, 1 plus 3 is 4. That is 386 into 11 is nothing but 4246. Why not we take 4 digit number? 7324, you take an example. 7324 into 11, you take 4 as unit digit. And then 2 plus 4, 6. There is no catching figure. You leave now 4 here. 2 plus 3, 5. Now you leave 2 here, and then 3 plus 7, 0, 1 is catching figure, right? 1 plus 7, 8. So, first you write 4, and then 4 plus 2, leave 4, 2 plus 3, 5, and then leave 2, 3 plus 7, 0, that is 3 plus 7, 10, you take 0 here, 1 is catching figure, 1 plus 7 is 8. So, if it is the number is in any digits, the number is in any digits, we can multiply 11 in this way. Take the unit digit as unit digit of our result, and then take two digits, leaving the last digits. Then you can obtain the result for multiplying any number by 11. So let us see how to multiply a number by 12. 12, you know that 5 into 2 is nothing but 10. 5 into 2 is nothing but 10. I am going to use 5 here. That is division of 5. Before that, to find the unit digit, you take the unit digit of multiplication of these two unit digits. 2 into 4 is 8. 2 into 4 is 8. Now, you divide this number by 5. Divide by this number by 5. What is the quotient? 34 divided by 5. Quotient is 6. Now, you add this 34 and 6. You get 40. So here, unit digit of this product is nothing but unit digit of product of these two unit digits, 4 and 2, 8. and then you divide by 5 and obtain the quotient. 34 divided by 5, the quotient is 6. 34 plus 6 is nothing but 40. You write that part. So 408 is nothing but 34 into 12. Likewise, if supposing 3 digits, if you want to multiply 145 into 12, the last digit is nothing but 0. 2 into 5, 10. 0. And then you need not take about the balance here. You leave 5 into 2 is 10. You take the unit digit alone, not taking one as catching figure on all. Here, 145 divided by 2. 145 divided by 2. Sorry, 145 divided by 5. Here, 2, 9. You add this one. 145 divided by 5. First, 14 divided by 5. 2 is the quotient. 4 is the balance. 45. 45 is divided by 9. It yields 9. So, 29 is nothing but 145 divided by 5. You add these two. This is nothing but 1740. 1740. You can easily verify. 145 into 12. 12 into 5, 66. 12 into 4, 48 plus 6. 54, 5, 12 into 1 plus 5, 1740, if you know the table 12. But for our multiplication, we need not know our 12 table. Directly we can do 145 into 12. Just 5 into 2 is nothing but 0, our unit digit. And then 145 divided by 5, the quotient is 29. Add these two, you get 1740. Why not we extend to this for 4 digits? First, 6 into 2, 12. The unit digit is 2. This divided by 5. 14. 6. 5. And then add these 2. Eight, seven, nine, one, two. Here, first 6 into 2, 12. You take the unit digit 2. You need not bother about that balance, catching fear. You don't worry about that one. You leave as it is. Here, 7326 divided by 5, the quotient, 14, 32, 6, and then 5. Here also, you need not worry about the remainder. Now, 8791. 8791 is this one. So, to multiply a number by 12, you can use this idea. If the number is in any digit, if suppose the number is 78563 into 12, how can you multiply? 3 into 2. 6 and then divide by 5, 15, 7, 1, 2, add this, 3 plus 2, 5, 7, 12, 9, 4, 2, 7, 5, 6. To multiply 7, 8, 5, 6, 3 by 12, the answer is this one. Then what we are doing, 3 into 2 is 6 and then 7, 8, 5, 6, 3 divided by 5, we are obtaining the quotient. You have to take the quotient is 5 one time and then 28 5 times and then 35 7 times, 6 1 times and then 1 3 divided by 5 2 times. You need not worry about the remainder now, you leave as it is. Here also if there is any catching figure, you divide. Here just we have to find the unit digit for that and then divided by 5 and add this, you get the result. Here in this manner we can find to multiply any number by 11 and 12. And 15 we will see in the next session. So you can see this and then you try to practice it. Practice it. It will be helpful for any competitive examination like for CAT or any other examination like civil service examination or some public service commission examination or bank examination. So it is helpful. You subscribe it and then you like it and share it. Ask your friends to subscribe it and ask them to share it and like it. Thank you, viewers. Thank you.